Today's video is sponsored by AnyCubic, but let me be totally upfront. While this is a paid collaboration, my reactions and opinions are entirely my own. I've owned several 3D printers in the past, including a dual filament setup, and I can't even count how many times I've spent struggling to get decent two-color prints and for the most part just gave up. So when I saw the Cobra 3 V2 combo, I had to react to their launch video because honestly, this might just fix the problems I gave up on trying to solve with my older printers. So I'm going to play this video and see my honest reaction.
We are constantly thinking about how to elevate your creative experience. Today, we're...
Now that's cool that AnyCubic does have its own slicer, because a lot of times you got to buy your own separately, and that's just an additional cost. And the problem with using a third-party slicer is that although it can work fine, it's not necessarily specifically designed to work with your exact hardware. So when the manufacturer themselves releases their own slicer, you should be able to get some of the best polished experience possible.
We're turning dreams into reality. Introducing the latest AnyCubic Cobra 3 V2. A more intuitive, more powerful, and more easy to use multicolor 3D printer.
So the 3D printer that I had previously that had dual filaments, it only had dual filaments and I had all sorts of problems with it. This looks really slick because it looks like it's kind of like a cartridge design. Think of like a regular printer that has different color cartridges for printing, but with filament. Now, I am curious if you can mix different types of filaments on various designs. Maybe they'll answer that.
Featuring 8 color printing, inspiration is at your fingertips.
8 colors is a lot of colors to be 3D printing on a single object. I gotta give it that. And wow, this is pretty cool. Like, if you look at this red sports car, you got like the emblem, and then the wheels, the tires, windows, everything. This is cool.
Improved auto leveling makes every model you create never fail to impress.
Now, auto leveling, I gotta talk about this. That is life-changing because I've had printers without that, and you could spend like 30 minutes just trying to get it perfectly level with a piece of paper and between the base plate and the extruder. And auto leveling is life-changing. Once you experience it, you can't go back.
Upgraded nozzle. Act filament drying helps you precisely craft your masterpiece.
The filament drying is kind of interesting to me because I live in Phoenix, so it's a very dry climate. So I'm not sure that I've actually experienced any issues with needing to dry it because everything dries pretty quickly here. But from my understanding, talking to people outside of the Phoenix area that do have 3D printers, this is the norm for the rest of the world. So that is also a cool feature too. But I am curious if it would make a difference for me in my existing climate.
Included 720p HD camera for remote monitoring.
Now, having a webcam that's built into the unit is actually a very, very nice feature. And the reason for that is because with how long it takes to print things, I'm assuming that you can remotely view this via an app. But anyways, I've set up surveillance cameras in my home office when I didn't have a machine that was capable of doing that. And I'd have to like remotely cut the power if there was an issue because the machine might not be able to detect that. So I am curious on what other features that make it more of a seamless process.
The latest AnyCubic K3 V2. Vibrant, versatile, visionary.
Now, I am curious because it showed that it was playing behind him while he was playing video games on how quiet or loud it is, because I've had some loud units and newer units seem to be quieter. I am curious on what that would sound like. So overall, this actually looks pretty cool. Being able to print up to 8 colors is a massive game changer if you want to print like just really cool detailed stuff. I am curious on how fast and noisy that it can get, but I'm also curious on how quiet you might be able to tune it. And I'd like to be able to see what their app experience is, especially with the remote viewing, and if there's any type of like notifications or anything that might be able to pop up and notify you in the event of a failed print, or if it'll just keep printing like my older printers used to do. Let me know down in the comments section below if you have any specific questions or things that you like or dislike about this printer, and I'll speak directly with Anycubic and see if they can give official answers to all of your questions. And I'll catch you in the next one.